Welcome back everybody. Now I'm just going to go ahead and show you that the installation did actually go through as planned. So here's the machine, and now I'm just going to click on reboot. This is going to take a bit of time. I will later on to the machine that we're going to be using as our main operating system, as our Red Hat virtualized environment. I will assign far more resources there. I'll even assign more CPU cores and more RAM so that it works faster. But for the time being, let's just see how this works in a bit of a slower mode. So you might have noticed that even though I've clicked reboot at the end of the Red Hat installation, I am booting now into Windows 8.1. And you might think this to be an error or something of a kind, but I assure you it is not. Everything is working as it should be working. Just type in test. We'll wait for it. Okay, now Windows is notorious for only seeing the partition of NTFS and XFAT, but let's just give it a shot anyway to see if we can actually see the Red Hat partitions there. So type in disk management. Thank you very much. And then I'll restart the computer and show you that you can indeed boot into Red Hat without any bigger problems, but you need to click a button in time. Okay, so it does see VirtualBox edition. Okay, so CD disk one. Okay, yep, yeah, there we go. So disk zero and disk one, they're the same size, and it just recognizes these partitions as healthy primary partitions, nothing more. It even sees only two, which is kind of weird, but okay. Anyway, don't pay that much attention to disk zero, primarily because I've done so many wrong things to it. Up to this point of time, I'm actually even surprised that it's working properly. What I want to show you here is the disk zero and how is it working. Anyway, if you need to free up some space here in the disk management while I'm here, I might as well show you. You can actually shrink these volumes. You shouldn't mess around with these that are not Windows partitions. You should only mess around with Windows partitions in Windows. In Linux, you can mess around with pretty much anything. But let's just right-click on it, and there's a shrink volume. Okay. So you can right-click and shrink it. Squaring volume for available shrink space. Anytime now, my good man. Anytime. I don't know, I've already shrank it, so to say, something here, and I have partitioned it. And here, excellent. So here it says shrink volume C, size available to shrink in megabytes is actually zero because it can't get any smaller. And the amount of space to shrink in megabytes you would just put in here. Once that is done, you just read the total size in megabytes after shrink and click shrink. There you go. You can only shrink them from left to right. You cannot shrink them from right to left. So one thing to keep in mind. Anyway, while I was here, I figured I might as well show you that, although not particularly relevant for the course, but a bit of extra information is always in handy. Anyway, I just want to show you that these two partitions are, in fact, in existence. They are very much there, but Windows doesn't have a clue as to what they actually are. So I'll just go ahead and close this. As you would do with your normal machine, with your physical machine, let's just restart. And now in the restart process, once the Windows goes down, we will switch to Red Hat. So press F12 to select the boot device. You will have something similar on your machine. I don't know, it depends from which machine. I have a Dell, so for Dell, it's F12. There are some other machines, like it's F2. Somewhere it's actually the delete button. It will be written on the screen as soon as you turn the machine on, that first black screen. So don't worry about it. Just have a look at it. And it's going to say, like, this is for BIOS. This is for boot options. Select the one, press the key for boot options, and you will get something similar to this. So either you will choose with an up and down arrow and then press enter, or you will have numbers and letters like I have here. So I'm just going to say boot from hard disk 2. And there you go. I have Red Hat here standing by. I also have Ubuntu down here, but disregard that, please. Been messing around with Windows and been trying to dual boot it on a single partition. Have encountered a lot of problems and didn't want to burden you with it. That's why it actually sees the Ubuntu here. But in any case, disregard that. You will not see that upon when you install it. Rather, instead, you will only see these two options that I am switching in between. Now, select the first one, press enter, and very shortly, Red Hat will actually boot. So you will have dual boot set up, working, no problems. As far as I could find on the forums and in consultation with a lot of people on the net who know a great deal about this, and after reviewing a lot of forum posts, as I've said before, I've actually opted for this method to physically separate Windows and Linux disks, and then you just boot, select the boot options at machine startup. Safest way to go about things without actually messing up anything. So anyway, accept the license agreement, done, finish configuration, and it's gonna boot any moment now. Come on. No, I would like to register at a later time because I don't want to register twice. I've already registered on a different machine. So it's booting into. This is the first boot, so keep that in mind. Excellent, there we go. Let's just log in. I'm not going to bother installing VirtualBox guest editions here, primarily because there's no need to do so, as we're not actually going to be using this machine. This is only a demonstration of the procedure itself. Oh, come on, anytime now. Just want to show it to you as proof. There you go. So it did indeed boot. You now have the working environment, the graphical user interface here, and it works no problems. Then if you want to switch back to Windows, just reboot the machine, press the key on your keyboard that is appropriate to your computer, to your computer brand, and select the hard drive from which you wish to boot. So one hard drive will be for Windows and another one will be for Red Hat. Very simple procedure, not too complex, and the only thing that you could possibly mess around with, the only possible thing that you could do that would cause you damage is to actually select the wrong drive during the partitioning part of the installation and delete the Windows partition. So just be careful with that and all should go well. In any case, I would like to cut the tutorial here, and in the next one we will actually start using Red Hat, and I will introduce you to the graphical user interface, not only of Red Hat but GNOME. GNOME is the general graphical user interface for Linux distributions, and then we'll move on slowly into the command line. Anyway, until then, I bid you all farewell.